We know that as long as the angle remains constant, the value of trigonometrical ratios remain constant. That is, for a fixed angle, the value of sine, cos, tan, etc. remains the same no matter how big or small the triangle is. So let us find the value of trigonometrical ratios for angle 30 degree. For that, we take an equilateral triangle. Each side is equal to 2x. We know that each angle of an equilateral triangle is equal to 60 degree. So all the angles are equal to 60 degree. Now, for a right angle triangle, we need a 90 degree. So from this point, we drop a 90 degree, that is a perpendicular line to BC. So we have AD perpendicular to BC. So if we consider these two triangles, that is triangle ABD and triangle ACD, triangle ABD and triangle ACD, then angle D is a right angle in both. So angle ADB is equal to angle ADC equal to 90 degree. So we have a right angle. Now this side, which is the hypotenuse in triangle ABD, is 2x. The hypotenuse of triangle ACD is also 2x. So the hypotenuse is equal in both. AB equal to AC equal to 2x. So right angle, hypotenuse, and side AD is common to both. So we have AD equal to AD. So we have a right angle, we have hypotenuse, and we have side. So by RHS, that is right angle, hypotenuse, side congruency, these two triangles are congruent. Triangle ABD and triangle ACD are congruent by RHS axiom. This means that this angle is equal to this angle. Now this angle, this entire angle was 60 degree. Since this angle is equal to this angle, this will be 30 degree. Also, BD equal to DC. Now since BC equal to 2x and BD equal to DC, BD will be equal to x. So for triangle ABD, we have this angle is 60. This is 30, this is 90, this side is x and this side is 2x. So we have a right angle triangle with one angle 30, the other angle 60, and this is the right angle. This side is x and this side is 2x. Now let us find AD. So use Pythagoras theorem, that is AB square, which is the square of hypotenuse, is equal to AD square plus BD square. Now AB is 2x. So we have 2x whole square is equal to AD square. AD is unknown. Plus BD square. BD is x. This implies AD square is equal to 2x whole square, which is 4x square, minus x square, equal to 3x square. So from here we have AD is equal to root over 3x, considering only the positive root. So AD is equal to root 3x. So from here, AD is root 3x. So now we have all the three sides of this triangle in terms of x. So let us find the trigonometrical ratios corresponding to the 30 degree angle. So corresponding to the 30 degree angle, The opposite side is this side, that is BD. This is the opposite side. The hypotenuse is AB. So this is the hypotenuse. And the adjacent side is AD. So this is the adjacent side. So this is what we have. Now we need to find sine of 30. Remember, we are doing it corresponding to the 30 degree angle, because this is the side opposite to the 30 degree angle. So sine of 30. First let us write so ka toa. Now sine is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. So sine 30 is equal to opposite of 30 degree angle divided by hypotenuse. Opposite of 30 degree angle is x divided by hypotenuse, which is 2x. So this is x by 2x. Now x by 2x is equal to half. So we get sine 30 equal to half. Now let us find cos 30 degree. Cos is adjacent by hypotenuse. So the adjacent side of 30 degree is root 3x. Adjacent by hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is 2x. So this is 2x. So we get root 3 divided by 2. So the value of cos 30 degree is root 3 divided by 2. Now tan 30. We know that tan 30 will be equal to sine 30 divided by cos 30, because tan is the ratio of sine and cosine. So tan of an angle is given by sine of that angle divided by cos of that angle. So tan 30 is equal to half divided by root 3 by 2. Now 2 and 2 get cancelled. So we get 1 by root 3. So tan 30 is 1 by root 3. Now cosec 30 degree is the reciprocal of sine 30 degree. Reciprocal of sine 30 degree means the reciprocal of half, which is equal to 2. So cosec 30 degree is equal to 2. Sec 30 degree is the reciprocal of cos 30 degree, which is equal to the reciprocal of root 3 by 2, that is 2 by root 3. Cot 30 degree is the reciprocal of tan 30 degree, that is the reciprocal of 1 by root 3, which is equal to root 3. So these are the values of the trigonometrical ratios corresponding to the angle 30 degree. So when the angle is 30 degree, the value of sine 30 will always be half, no matter what the length of the sides of the triangle be. Cos 30 degree is always root 3 by 2. Tan 30 degree is always 1 by root 3, and so on. So these values are constant or fixed for a specific angle, and we need to remember these values for angles like 30 degree. So you need to remember all these values. Now let us find the trigonometric ratios corresponding to the angle 60 degree. We see that we have a 60 degree here, and we also know the sides of this right angle triangle in terms of x. So yes, we can find the trigonometric ratios corresponding to 60 degree from the same diagram. First, let us mark the opposite and the adjacent sides of 60 degree. So for 60 degree, this side is the opposite side. This side is the hypotenuse. And this side is the adjacent side. Now, we have so, ka toa sine 60 sine 60 is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. Opposite of 60 degree is root 3x. So this is root 3x divided by hypotenuse, which is 2x. So this is equal to root 3 by 2. X and x get cancelled. This is equal to root 3 by 2. Sine 60 is equal to root 3 by 2. Now cos 60 degree is equal to adjacent by hypotenuse. Adjacent is x and hypotenuse is 2x. X by 2x is half. So cos 60 degree is half. Tan 60 is sine 60 by cos 60. So root 3 by 2 divided by half. So tan 60 is equal to root 3 by 2 divided by half. Now this 2 and this 2 get cancelled. So we are left with root 3. So tan 60 is root 3. Now cosec 60. Cosec is the reciprocal of sine. So cosec 60 is 2 by root 3. So we have cosec 60 as 2 by root 3. Sec 60. Sec is the reciprocal of cos. So sec 60 is the reciprocal of cos 60 degree. That is the reciprocal of half, which is equal to 2. Cot 60 degree is the reciprocal of tan 60 degree. That is the reciprocal of root 3, which is equal to 1 by root 3. So these are the trigonometrical ratios corresponding to 60 degree, and you need to remember their values. So no matter what the length of the sides of the triangle be, when the angle is 60 degree, the values of these trigonometrical ratios is fixed. So sine 60 is always root 3 by 2. Cos 60 is always half. Tan 60 is always root 3, and so on. Now you might be wondering, why exactly do we need to remember these trigonometrical ratios? Why are we studying the trigonometrical ratios corresponding to different angles? Well, we are doing this because they are very useful in some real life application problems. Let us see one. A ladder is placed at an angle of 30 degree with the ground. It reaches the house at a height of 10 meter. Find the length of the ladder. So we have this ladder here. It reaches a height of 10 meter. So this height, it is 10 meter. And it makes an angle of 30 degree with the ground. So this is the ground, and the ladder makes an angle 30 degree. This angle is 30 degree. We need to find the length of the ladder. So this is the situation like, this angle is 30 degree, this side is 10 meter. We need to find the length of the ladder. Let us name this as A, B, C. We can clearly see that this is a right angle. Now we know one angle and one side. We need to find this side. If we consider this angle 30 degree, then this side, it is the opposite side of 30 degree. So it is the opposite side. Whereas this side, that is the length of the ladder, which we need to find is the hypotenuse. And we know this angle is 30 degree. Now what is the trigonometrical ratio corresponding to opposite side and hypotenuse? It is sine, because sine 30 degree is equal to opposite by hypotenuse, which is equal to, opposite is AB and hypotenuse is AC. Now AB is 10 meters and we need to find AC. So if we know the value of sine 30 degree, we can find AC. So we are given one side, we know this angle is 30. So if we know the value of sine 30, we can find the length of the ladder. And we have already learned the value of sine 30. The value of sine 30 is half. So putting this value of sine 30 equal to half, we get half is equal to 10 by AC. This implies AC is equal to 10 into 2, that is 20 meters. So we see that the length of the ladder is 20 meter. So we can solve similar problems using these trigonometrical ratios. So now you see why it is important to learn the trigonometrical ratios for these special angles, because they help us solve some real life application based problems.